Today we're taking a look at the exciting new features that DJI has added to their latest firmware release to the MATRICE 300. Stay tuned. Hi, it's Danny from DSLRPros, and welcome to Release Notes, where we talk about the latest hardware, software, and firmware updates in the commercial drone industry. Today, I'm going to give you a brief overview of the newly released version 3 firmware for DJI's MATRICE 300. Let's get right into it and start with the first new feature. First, we're going to talk about the ability to update your drone offline. If your drone has previously had trouble connecting to a secure network, this update will be a huge benefit. After the version 3 update, you'll be able to download the installation package and place it right into the root directory of an external SD card or on the internal memory of your remote control, and then update as you normally would rather than having to be connected to the internet. You're now able to clear your flight logs with just one click. This is perfect for missions that you want to remain confidential or for sharing equipment between teams. Just a note that this feature is currently only supported by the H20 series payloads. For sensitive data, the new encryption feature allows you to password protect your SD card. This feature will require a password on drone startup to write or read data, and will also require a password to access that data. This new encryption system ensures your confidential data is protected in case of a drone crash or even a malfunction. The new network security mode allows users to customize their network security settings with three modes. Standard mode has no restrictions on connecting to DJI's network. Restricted network mode allows access to map service, network RTK, and third-party live streaming. But all other network services are disabled. And finally, there's local data mode, where no network requests will be sent in order to protect your data. The pre-flight checklist has now been updated and optimized. It uses a new color scheme that's easier to read and is now contained on just one page instead of the previous two. New options include maximum altitude, max flight distance, out of control action, obstacle avoidance distance, and battery warning, among others. The M300 now has an enhanced frequency selection strategy to increase and optimize its anti-interference capabilities. You're also provided now with more information as to the nature of the transmission signal status and whether the issue is from the remote controller or the aircraft itself. This is important because it will allow pilots to better assess the situation when flying in areas with high potential signal interference. Now in the Health Management System menu, you're able to check historical flight data, purchase drone maintenance services, and buy DJI Care Enterprise services. This is great for giving you a snapshot of your drone's health. With the version 3 firmware, you can now mute all alerts, like when the remote control warns you when it's time to land your drone. This could be a big one if the beep from the remote control annoys you. Next up is multi-pin, which allows you to use multiple pin points. You can add, delete, or edit pins with color, GPS position, elevation, and descriptions. You can even change any pin to your home location and share pins with other team members. This is extremely handy in search and rescue scenarios where a pilot can mark multiple targets or points of interest and then share them with other team members. Coordinated turn allows the nose of the aircraft to be pointed in the same direction as the flight path without side slip. You'll never again have to guess about the direction your craft is flying when relying on the first-person view from the drone. This is useful when the drone is far away from the pilot and the direction of the craft is difficult to judge or the aircraft is out of line of sight. The compensation value can now be adjusted for certain payloads to achieve optimal vertical accuracy. This is especially important when using the M300 for surveying and mapping applications. The M300 and H20 series payloads can now take a panoramic photo with a single click. It works by taking multiple photos from different angles and then stitching them together. This can be used to capture a quick, all-encompassing photo of a disaster site or be used in a host of other scenarios. With this new firmware upgrade, flying in restricted areas has become that much easier for those who are authorized to fly in those spaces. Before, the craft would have to take off and land inside the restricted area in order for it to operate there. Now, as long as the height of the craft is at the legally approved level, the craft is able to fly into and out of these restricted areas. For those who are flying into and out of restricted airspace, the pilot app will alert you when you are near the border of those areas. Also keep in mind, to fly in any restricted airspace, you must receive clearance from the proper authorities. All right, so this covers most of the new features of interest in the V3 update. If you have any questions about this latest firmware release or DJI's Matrice 300, just give us a call, email us, or visit us at dslrpros.com. I'm Danny, thanks for tuning in, and fly safe.